Well, a half million sandhill cranes should be enough to make any river well known. But to many people, the Platte River remains an enigma. My name is Doreen Pfost. I'm a writer, and one of the things that I've written about is the Platte River and sandhill cranes and the habitat along the Platte. The Platte attracts tens of thousands of bird watchers each year, but many of them don't know much about the river beyond the tiny little window that they stand by in their observation blind. My husband's job in 2004 took us to Kearney, Nebraska. I encountered this strange river that was unlike anything I had ever seen before. I traveled the river over the course of 6 years from the parklands of the Rocky Mountains to the Missouri River. There's really no substitute for getting outside and seeing and experiencing the natural world. Having to learn about the river and understand it so that I could explain it to other people caused me to really slow down and pay attention to it. Without the Platte River, the sandhill cranes wouldn't be here. The river's flowing here all year round, but when the birds come here in March, they're experiencing the effects of what's happened on the river during the entire previous year. The first spring migration that I saw was in 2005, the year after we moved to Kearney for my husband's job, and I came out in the spring thinking I'd probably see a few hundred cranes, which would be neat compared to having seen a few here and a few there over the years in Wisconsin. And what we saw, instead of a few hundred birds or a couple thousand birds, was probably a good 10,000 birds landing right outside the blind. I was entranced right off the bat, and I guess I was hooked. So I've been coming to the Platte for the migration ever since. For the years that we lived here, I was volunteering at Rose Sanctuary and taking other people out to the blind so that they could have the experience of seeing the cranes. So what do you say? Should we take a walk? This is the main habitat area for sandhill cranes and whooping cranes and a number of other creatures that depend on the broad grading channels along here and the grasslands that line the river.
Kearney traffic, sky 4710 Papa, taxi to runway 18.
Flying the whooping crane surveys makes me feel like I'm part of something bigger. During migration, our job is to spot whoopers that have roosted overnight on the Platte. The purpose is to gain more understanding of the habitat characteristics that migrating whooping cranes prefer.
We have a small flock of sandhill cranes down there and then a small flock of snow geese.
Are you seeing them?
Yeah, snow geese? Yeah. They were like that, the smaller birds that were flying behind the sandhill cranes.
Hey, yep.
To me, the cool thing about flying, and especially over the Platte, is that everything starts to make sense and all the pieces fit together. You can see the little abandoned channels and where the water comes from and where it's going, and everything seems orderly and beautiful. It's an unusual experience to be surrounded by that much life, that there's a visceral reaction that you have when suddenly an entire river full of birds lifts up into the air. It makes you feel alive and it makes you feel connected with the natural world. The fact that we have that right here in the heart of North America, it's something people ought to see.